Hey guys, welcome to the channel. I hope you're doing well. Well, as you can see what's laid out here in front of us, you probably guessed it, we're going to be taking a look at some multimeters. Well, this multimeter in particular. This meter, the TS-618U, is a US military multimeter that I can't find much information about, so I thought it's a good opportunity to kind of show you guys around this meter. We'll take a look inside and see what we could learn from it. On that note, if you're interested in learning about your particular multimeter, there's no shortage of videos available that show how to use your meter, how to keep yourself safe when you're using it, how to keep your meter safe when you're using it. I should probably watch a few of those.
Who the f*** left the meter in the current mode?
Today I want to just showcase some of the similarities and differences in a lot of these meters. And at the end of this video, I'm going to show you guys my favorite meter. So if any of that sounds interesting, stick around. We're going to get right into it. Well, I want to first start by talking about some of the similarities in these meters in particular. These are digital multimeters. You can tell by the digital display that you see. As compared to analog multimeters that have an analog display. This one is also analog. I'll show you that in just a bit as soon as we clear this table off. Something else that's in common, you'll see on these meters we have push buttons. These meters have dials. They all have some form of dial and push button. That's usually, in this case, it's to select the range in which you're going to be testing. Newer meters have a feature called auto-ranging, many of them do, and what that allows the meter to do is to auto-range based off of the component or circuit that's being tested. We also have something called a VTVM, a vacuum tube voltmeter. As compared to a regular multimeter, a VTVM contains vacuum tubes, and this one in particular has the coolest and smallest vacuum tube that I've seen. You know, I should probably take this meter out of its case. And if you're wondering, no, it's not a Fluke meter. I have nothing against Fluke meters. They're worth their weight in gold. I guess that's really my issue with them, is their cost is about the same as gold. And as hard as I am on some of my meters, if I plug a probe in the wrong port and I test something I shouldn't test and I damage the meter, well, it's not the end of the world. You do that with a Fluke meter, it's a big deal. These meters here are much more expendable, if you will. Fluke meter, well, not so much. This meter here is really special in that it's able to test up to 600 amps, enough to put you in the ground permanently. These meters here will go up to 10, in this one's case, 20 amps, but 600 amps, yeah, that's the real deal. So now that we've checked them all out, let's go ahead and get them off the bench and we'll open up this one in particular. What I want to do is try something that I learned here and see if it works. Bear with me, let's try this out. Hello? Hey, where'd you guys go? Hello? Okay, we're back. Let's try again. Well, that's a little better. Kai, what are you doing sleeping again? Wake up! There, that's better. Well, this is the meter that we've been waiting to see. It's got a neat case that surrounds it, making it much more rugged. It's got a kickstand here. We'll see that in just a second. And the backside has its placard, and this back section is the power supply for this meter. This is a shot of the top of it. And then here's the bottom. It's not super clean. It's got quite a few scuffs and scratches, rust, some paint chips here and there. But overall, it's in pretty fair shape. Let's go ahead and get this front panel off. We'll look at the inside of it. And I only want to take this apart one time, because it's really brittle. So let's take this item apart. We're gonna start with the battery compartment on the back. So let's take off this top case. And there's a plug right here, so I'm going to go ahead and undo this plug. I'll put some pictures of the batteries that run this voltmeter on the screen. The BA-30 are for the heater of the vacuum tube. This connector here goes into the battery BA-414-U. This connector here plugs this unit into the main meter. Now let's go ahead and take the face off. There we go. Now let's open up this case. Can you guys spot the cutest vacuum tube you've ever seen? Let me zoom in on it here. That's them. That is the 6418 vacuum tube. And this one here is a spare. Let's go ahead and take a closer look. Here's a shot of the schematic. And then that connector there. Here's a more detailed shot of the sides, the left and right side of the meter. Well, all we have left to do now is put it back together. Do we dare try it again? Of course we do. Hey, haven't we already been here before? Try again.
Honey, you blew the breaker again.
And there you have it. The US Multimeter TS-618U, built in 1955 to 1960. And as promised, here's a shot of my favorite multimeter. Well, it's not actually a multimeter, but it does do multiple functions. If you guys are interested in me doing a video just on that oscilloscope, let me know. Thanks for hanging out with me. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day or evening. We'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.